John Boehner stunned the political world on Friday by announcing he was stepping down as Speaker of the House and resigning from Congress after 5 years of Republican infighting and dysfunction, which brings us to a segment called Bye Bye Boehner. Boehner was third in line from the presidency and the second most powerful man in Washington. Rising to the position of Speaker was, by all accounts, the culmination of a lifelong dream for the Ohio congressman, so he must have been sad to step down. Here he is after the announcement.
It's a wonderful day.
I would say he's glowing, but remember, he always looks like that. So why is Boehner so happy to be walking away from a job he worked his whole life to get? Because it finally dawned on him that it's the worst job on earth. There are two wings of the Republican Party, the far right wing that believe Obama must be stopped at any and all costs, and the farther right wing that believes the same thing but are louder and crazier about it. And it was that farther right wing that drove Boehner out. And to be clear, Boehner is no moderate. He blocked immigration reform and scheduled more than 50 votes to repeal Obamacare. Yet despite his conservative credentials, here's how the audience at Friday's Values Voter Summit reacted when Marco Rubio announced Boehner's resignation.
Just a few minutes ago, Speaker Boehner announced that he will be resigning.
That's how NASA reacted when they found out Matt Damon was still alive on Mars. Can you imagine being as conservative as Boehner and not being conservative enough? He must feel like the Riddler the day the Joker showed up in Gotham. But I also hate Batman. Yeah, but so does he, and he's a f-ing lunatic about it. One of the conservatives pressuring Boehner to shut down the government this time was Ted Cruz, who celebrated Boehner's resignation on the campaign trail. Boehner was asked how he felt about Cruz on CBS This Weekend. Let's see if he took the high road.
I'll refer you to my remark at a fundraiser I made in August in Steamboat Springs, Colorado.
You called Ted, I believe the word you used was jackass, referring to
Senator Cruz. To that same remark.
All right.
I'm referring to that same remark. It's like entering a burn into the public record. You called him a jackass?
That is correct.
Would you like to amend the statement?
I'd like to add a suck it.
So Republicans didn't get along with Boehner, but that doesn't mean Democrats did. Nancy Pelosi was asked how she felt about Boehner yesterday on CNN. Here she is.
Are you going to miss him?
Well, I respect my colleagues.
There was also no love lost between Boehner and the president, who had very different styles. Boehner said of his negotiations with Obama in 2013, quote, "All you need to know about the differences between the president and myself is that I'm sitting there smoking a cigarette, drinking Merlot, and there is the president of the United States drinking iced tea and chomping on Nicorette." You know, if you're gonna put someone down with an iced tea and Nicorette comment, maybe leave out the Merlot on your end. Also, cigarettes and Merlot, are you a congressman or Joy Behar on vacation? So to recap, Boehner and Pelosi don't get along. Boehner and Obama don't get along. Boehner and his own caucus don't even get along. Who does Boehner get along with? Well, the better question is not who, but what. Because there's one thing John Boehner does love, and that's mowing the lawn. Here's an actual video his office posted last year.
I love green grass.
You guys, he loves green grass. And who can blame him? Because unlike an extreme right wing of your own party, when grass gets out of control, it's legal to cut that down. So it doesn't seem like Boehner's resignation will make things any better in Washington, and in fact, they'll probably get worse. But one person who won't have to worry about it, John Boehner. And let's tip our cap to a politician who resigned, not because of a scandal, but because he realized the job sucked so much, all the Merlot in the world couldn't get him through it. This has been Bye Bye Boehner.